It looks like you can find it anywhere. So it's like because you eat whatever.
Well, I'm probably on Man vs. Wild, and over the years I've become more of a scavenger, really. You know, it's always kind of finding, you know, rotten carcasses or whatever, which is more the reality of the wild, as trying to hunt down big food is super energy consuming, time consuming, high risk as well. So really, traditionally, it's why we were always hunter-gatherers. You know, you were, unless you were working as a team and you became very efficient at hunting, which we did as humankind. But really, as a survivor, you're conserving energy, you're minimizing risk, and you're going for the grubs and the berries and the roots, and being smart and not eating things that can either kill you or make you sick, which, of course, has happened to me many times.
Yeah, when did your stomach let you down?
It's the food choices let me down, you know. I remember eating one particularly dodgy snake that I found, and I should have known it was bad because it was stinking, I killed it. I'd eaten half and I'd kept the rest of it, and a day later it was smelling pretty bad, but I ate it, and I remember that. It was in, I'm trying to think where it was. I think it was in Namibia, and I was halfway up this rock face. And I said to the camera, I felt the diarrhea coming. You know what? So I went in. the tummy rumbling. It's not bad, you know. It's like, you all know what it's like, but you also know when that happens, you're on the time clock, you know. And I said to the camera, turn the camera off. This isn't going to wait to the top. I'm not going to make it to the top in time. You know? And so he was kind of, wait, you are a bit further away. And I hung on with one hand and used the other hand to get my trousers down. Wow. And then I don't know what time the show goes out. But,
you should have had this on camera.
Well, no, I did the diarrhea into free air, and there was a cameraman at the bottom who was like... But anyway...
So he was filming.
Well, no, the... I thought they weren't filming. At the end of it, I pulled my trailer. I thought, job done. And looked there, and there was a sort of red blinking light on the camera. And I thought, there's nothing sacred, you know. So, but, you know, that's been a big part of the show, big part of the adventures, the mistakes, as well as the... I mean, really, it's what I've tried to write about in this book. It's the failures and the mistakes and the struggles and the times it goes wrong, because that's life, isn't it? You know, that's how we learn and grow and... And
the book is called Never Give Up. And I wonder, talking about food, did you ever taste something that tastes so bad that you had to give up? You had to just, blah, I can't eat that.
Yeah, actually watching that little VT, that little clip, that beetle I was very wrong about, because it was actually a sting beetle. And I was quite confident going, it's not going to taste nice, but it's great, here we go. And it was just an explosion of like super kind of powerful acid that it squirted in my mouth. I thought instantly, this is like reaction, like, this isn't just bad, this is wrong. Get it out. But most of the time, I'm vaguely confident of what I'm doing, and I kind of think, yeah, that's pretty good. But,
You're sometimes...
Nobody ever comes around for dinner. I don't have to worry about calories.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. For more interesting conversations, please hit subscribe.